Beauty in the flame, and we don't know how much longer, but we know we're gonna come back stronger. Oh, just 'cause things are different don't mean anything, anything has changed.
I'll be the light, if you follow me, I will be everything you need. I'll be the leader, if you want it, I promise that I will set you free.
Some of us will drift apart while others stay together. Some will step in from the rain while others face the weather. Some will take the last breath while others breathe new life. And though they're standing on our necks, we still the will to fight. Just 'cause things are different don't mean changed. And I know the world's on fire, but there's beauty in the flame, and we don't know how much longer, but we know we're gonna come back strong. We'll lose ourselves while others rediscover. The love is in the innocence, a baby to its mother. The sun will grasp it in the hands while others lose control. Yeah, we gotta leave our fingerprints so that the future knows.
And then I picture all the perfect that we lived, till I cut the strings on your tiny violin. My mind's got a mind of its own right now, and it makes me hate me. I'll explode like a dynamite if I can't decide, baby. My head and my heart, I torture in me.
Okay, we're here now, just looking at the two teams warming up. As the programme goes, Liam, there's a few changes with Tinner Island, is there?
Yeah, there's a few changes on the Tinner Island team. Paul Doyle starts in goal instead of Daniel Dunnigan. Cathal Gaffney starts on the half-back line instead of Shane O'Neill. Greg Murphy has gone to the middle of the field instead of Mark Lawler, who's moved to the half-forward line instead of Dean Farrell. And Evan Doyle has gone into the full forward line instead of Owen Hosey. I'd say Evan will probably play in the centre, full forward there.
Okay.
In that, and Dinny will go onto the corner. Great day for a game of football here. The 2020 Junior A Championship Final played in
Network.
August, July 2021.
Yeah.
It's an unusual kind of a situation we find ourselves in, but sure, here we are. And
yeah.
The referee for today is
Billy Fannin.
Billy is the referee today.
No, Tuller are lined out as per the program there. So you might see a few positional changes, but that as it goes, 1-15, there shouldn't be any changes other than what the program has. It so in goal you have James Tobin, Darren Butler right corner back, Shane Rowan full back, and Lee Kavanagh left corner back, Dylan Hanley, Niall Sherry, Ronan Byrne, Willie Kahneman and Willie Dorn in the middle of the field, TJ Kavanagh, Dylan Gorman Comfort and Stephen Metcalf next to half hour line, Jack O'Kendy, Craig Staunton and Brian Byrne. That's the full forward line. I'd say there'll be a few positional changes as the game gets going, all right, Liam, but I'd say that's the 15 to start.
That's the 15 to start pitch, yeah.
The two teams, like, the last few years, Tin Rieland have to get the ups on the St. Patrick's lads, you know, in this junior competition, but they haven't really met in a knockout in a long time, you know.
Yeah, I would think it'll be a great match. I know it's Tin Rieland's second team, basically, but there are some of those lads would be knocking on the door of the senior team there when this game is over.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a strong enough team that goes out there today, and hopefully the rain will stay off now and let the game progress into a good contest, because it has all the potential to be a good contest.
Yeah, two young sides,
yeah, willing to play football, no messing, they'll get on with it.
Yeah, like, I was just looking back there in 2018, there was, I think, the under-19 competition, and St. Patrick just came out on top of Tin Rieland in that final, but that was a great game of football. So, like, there's six lads starting for St. Patrick's off that team, and overall there's about 18 involved in the panel.
Okay, you know, it's a great mixture then.
Yeah, so they're after Mick Keogh's after bringing through a lot of young lads, you know.
Yeah, and Mick could know some of the Tin Rieland lads too. He lives over there, and
yeah,
he lives just down the road from the field. But Mick will bring a new dimension to the game for Tullow, and he's a fine fella and a great manager.
Yeah.
I'm just looking there, Paul Dyle going into the goal. Paul is around a long time now. He'd be the senior man, I'd say, around here today. He's 40 maybe plus, and a great lad, great stalwart of the club. And when he was asked to go on goal when the need arose, yeah, he took the
fair
he
play
took
to
that.
Him.
Yeah.
Yeah, William Kahneman would be the Tullow's all the starting player. You notice on the program, Pádraig Murphy is not starting. Pádraig's after being out injured. He's a big loss for the Tullow team here today. So he is. Pádraig has a lot of experience. He was on the inter-county scene there for a good few years as well.
Okay.
You know, it's not only on the field, off the field as well. Like he's a real leader, and like he'd be a massive loss. But I know, no doubt, he's in the huddle there with them and getting them going. You know.
Yeah, Peter Hennessy now is injured as he's on the program there, but he was playing midfield with his team all along, and he's a big loss to Tin Rieland. But
okay,
these things happen, you know. And
yeah.
And you get on with it. There's a few good subs there to come in for Tin Rieland. Conor Brennan, Cormac McGilligott, Owen Hosey. I'd say they're disappointed not to be starting, but they're there ready to come in when
they need it. And likewise here on the Tullow team, Alan O'Neill, Owen O'Toole. So like the two boys, they're after being involved there for the last 15 years, you know. So they're not getting the start, but I'd say he has them kept. He's doing a Brian Cody on it. He's holding them until the last 20, you know.
Oh, I don't like to hear that. Brian Cody.
Yeah.
For them, he's far more done without.
That's there. But then you have a good bit of youth on the bench as well. So the likes of Niall Gann, Kyle Murray, David Orbinski, Tyke Black, these guys are off that under 19 team a few years ago I was talking about. And they're starting to come of age now, these guys. The extra year is after really helping them, you know. They're after filling out, they're after getting a bit fitter in the last year.
And you know,
so,
isn't it great to see lads continuing to play football? A lot of lads fall away from football at that age, and to see these lads here is a great joy.
Yeah.
You lose so many lads from that age group to progressing into the adult stages.
Yeah.
You know, it's great to see it. We're nearly ready to go now.
Nearly
it's
ready.
Only 2 minutes to...
Nice crowd. Nice. Bit of a crowd here, you know. I'd say there'd be a good atmosphere now.
There'd be a great atmosphere here, and there's no grudge around. It's just get on with football today.
Oh, it's 15 again, 15. Yeah.
A lot of the lads would know each other from different things, and there'd be nothing wrong there. They just get on with playing a good game of football.
Yeah.
I see Jacko there now. I know Jacko from other angles, and he's a great stalwart of the club there for Tullow as well.
Yeah, he's been playing. I was just looking at his stats there from last year. He's scoring 1.7, 1.8 a game, you know, so that's how important he is.
Like,
his free-taking ability is alone.
And his fitness levels are high too. He's always
a but like he was involved there under Turlough for 7 or 8 years there with the county as well. So you know,
he's a military man as well. He's in the army, and he's
just saying that I'm in the Defence Force myself. But there's six guys from the Defence Forces involved with St Patrick's today. So there is.
Yeah,
you have. So
Willie
Dorn, Owen O'Toole, Jack, Patrick Murphy, Jamie Ansborough, Will Dorn. So you have, Will Dorn is centre field, Jack Hendy, Patrick Murphy, Alan O'Neill, Owen O'Toole and Jamie Ansborough.
It's great to see them there, and the fitness levels will be high, and they'll be anxious to put in a good game. No, it's a great day for football. I see the referee there now is
yes, it's gone 3 o'clock there now, so we're getting ready.
Is that John Hickey he has with him there as a linesman? It looks a bit like him.
Yeah, I think that's John, yeah.
Looks like him, yeah.
I believe he'll be a man in the middle anyway, because he's a ballon man, so he's in between Tinrail and Tullo.
I hope he stays in the middle, that he doesn't drift towards one side.
He went to school in Tullo, maybe that will help.
He has to drive through Tinrail to get
yeah.
Just on the face of it, looking out at the teams there, Tinrail look a bigger. Now, maybe it's the jerseys are making them look like that.
Few very, very big men Tinrail have, actually.
Now, the jerseys might be inclined to do that as well, but Barry Power there and Cormac McGilligott and Conor Brennan and Mark Lawler, they seem they're big men.
Big men, yeah. Yeah, Tullo wouldn't be as big.
They could be livelier, though.
Yeah, they're fit, Ari. I've seen them recently. They held their own like in the Division 2 there this year, you know. They got to the playoffs and Clonmore pipped them in at the very end of it by a couple of points in the playoffs, and they bet Meisland went on last week to give it Runaway Rogue second team.
Okay.
You know, so Aerogue won that by a point, and they got a point in injury time, 6 minutes.
As they do.
Yeah, so like that's the level. So both teams are actually after being operating in the Division 2. So
I can't see this as being any way one-sided. It'll be a nip and tuck game.
Absolutely. And I can tell you now, coming from the Tullo side, there's no way they're expecting, you know, they're expecting a tough game.
Yeah. Just maybe you know, on a question of technicality, is the mark in this game today, or was it in?
Oh yeah, it was played in the league anyway.
No, but was it played in 2020 for the league?
I couldn't be 100% on that.
Oh, I was trying to figure that one out today. I don't think it was in for this competition.
Yeah,
and I'm just wondering are they going to play it today?
Yeah, I couldn't tell you 100%.
I know it's in now, and we played it this year, but I don't think we played it last year in this competition.
Evan Dial, he's around a long time.
Evan Dial is around a long time. He had a tournament with the county.
He did. I remember watching him up in Parnell Park one evening again, Dublin under Paul Beelan. He had an unbelievable game. He played left half back or centre back that night.
Yeah, he's a bit of a target man here today. He's going to be full forward, and whoever is marking him will surely find they'll have their hands full there.
Yeah, he's a big physical man.
And he's a clever man there. He knows how to read the game. We're nearly ready to go here now. He's just a few minutes behind here.
Yeah, he is, yeah.
The pitch is in splendid form there.
Yeah,
I've no
seen that coming
all.
In. The drop of rain is after putting a bit of green back in it as
it
well.
It has, and do you know, even with the rain, and I'd say that the matches, they're not maybe as many matches on it now, so it's after being a good year for the pitch in regards.
Yeah, after helping it out.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. There's a great Tullo crowd here today.
They
brought all their colours with them.
Yeah.
Now it's hard sometimes because it's blue and white and it's blue and yellow. So sometimes it's hard to see.
Well, I'm going back like onto the club. The structures over there now are second to none. You know, they really got the juvenile set up again back there, and you'll start seeing that in the next few years of teams coming through. You know,
like for a town the size of Tullo, you would expect. Maybe they would have a senior team, you know. And I know they did before, and it'd be great for the game if they did, you know, and bring it on to.
Yeah,
well, that's down there. I know rugby is strong in Tullow, and
that's
and,
it. You have
takes a lot of the young lads, but
you have a few different sports to see, but definitely the club is in a good area now, you know.
Yeah, and do you know if you could win something?
That's it.
It brings it on even more.
Yeah. If they could get over the line here today, I think, like, we've a good minor team this year as well, so there'll be a lot of them boys coming through next year, you know. So it'll be...
And try and keep the fall
keep
off.
Keep the fall off, yeah.
But to a minimum, yeah.
I always said you need a good second team to have a good first team. In 2005, we won the intermediate and we got to the Junior A final that year. Our second team did. The Blues beat us in the final that year. But that we had at that stage, like, there was 35 guys training in the field. But that's what you need. If you have good, two good teams going, you get the numbers in the field, yeah. and that brings the good spirit with it, you know.
His name is not going to start for another few minutes.
No, he's delaying it for some reason or another.
I think one of the crowd outside.
Oh, he delayed, did he? Yeah. He's after announcing it there, it's being delayed.
Yeah, there was a crowd outside. There was a queue outside for the turnstile, and they couldn't get in.
Yeah,
I got a call there from someone to know what was happening, that they couldn't get in. The queue was around the corner.
Yeah, so. Crowd going over to the far bank and all now.
Yeah. No, he's just announced everybody's in. So that was the delay.
Yeah.
Two turnstiles would have solved that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Justin Griffith. So who would you be looking out for there, Liam, in the Tinner Island forward line?
Ronan Curran comes to mind straight away, and Dinny Farrell, Pádraig Whelan. All of them, really, I suppose, are
good footballers.
Yeah, and Evan is well able to take a score. Alan Barrett, if he's on his day, not be beaten.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is a good mixture there of older and younger, I'll put it that way.
Right.
Middle of the field will be important now with the kickouts or that get out that far. Barry Power's a tall chap. God, he must be 6'6".
Yeah, Will Dorn now is in the middle of the field now. Will be very athletic. He's big enough chap as well now. He wouldn't be that tall, but he's able to get around the field.
Yeah.
He's a big physical chap. Will Canavan, that's Larry's son.
Oh, yeah.
He's starting in midfield. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if he goes into centre-forward.
Right, okay. You know, so that's, move it around a little bit.
Yeah, I think he'll go into centre-forward. But you'll see Stephen Metcalf going into middle of the field, I'd say. Yeah.
Right.
We'll see what the way they line out at the start. They're going as they're starting.
Yeah, I see.
That's the line out, so.
Yeah, there's Mark there going down to... That's number five. Yeah, he's parking Dylan Hanley. That's his...
They're related.
Yeah, they are. Through their mothers. Their cousins through their mothers.
Right.
And, it's interesting.
Dylan is a fine young footballer.
So I believe.
Fine young footballer. He's coming of age now this year, you know.
There's a little bit of a height gap there, but...
Yeah.
If
he can keep with him.
Yeah, that's the thing. So, yeah, as I said, Greg Murphy's in the middle of the field with Barry Power. And, yeah, they're lining out pretty much as we suspected. And the game is on now. And it's Barry Power tops it down to Greg Murphy, over to Dinny Farrell. Dinny is looking. He's out on the wing now, and he gives it to Ronan Curran. Ronan Curran is looking for the runners. He's looking for Evan Dyle. Evan comes out. Yes, nice ball from Evan. Or to Evan.
Holding him up there. Good tackle by Lee Kavanagh. They're just holding them up, being patient. Two teams are being patient.
Yeah, that's coming to Peeney Whelan there. Peeney then. Eyes.
Good tackle, good turnover.
Yeah, Peeney was looking for a free there, but didn't get it.
There's Niall Sherry coming through. Monaghan native. On to TJ Kavanagh. Great ball from TJ into Craig Staunton. Craig is after it. Get down on Craig. Well done, Craig.
Padder Doran is there.
He's holding him.
Padder is trying
well
to hold
Craig
him.
Well done, Craig
Staunton. He's gone around
Jack Kennedy. And a first score for Jacko. Best score, Jacko.
That was a very good score for Jack Kennedy. Jack took that very well when
best
he got the chance.
Craig Staunton did very well. He had a lot of work to do.
He did, but he got it into Jacko. I'd say he's going to be the target man here now.
You see what way the kick-out's going out tonight. It'll probably go along with all their big men.
I'd say it might drop over towards Barry Power there. I see the pull lads across. Yeah, that's what I thought might happen. Across to Barry.
Well done.
Barry knocked it down, but down to a Tullaman.
Off we go. TJ Kavanagh's on the ball. Now a good ball in.
No, the goal
into the keeper's hands.
Paul Doyle out to Kieran Larkin. Kieran Larkin coming up along the wing now on the left-hand side. He's going into the middle. He's giving it to Dinny Farrell. Dinny is looking around for options. He has Gaffney to his right.
Metcalf is chased, tracking him back.
He's Ronan Corngon taking a run to the right, but he didn't spot him. He has Mark Lawler to his left, but he gives it back to Kieran Larkin. Good pass in. Kieran Larkin takes a shot from out the field. Ah, look, that's a lovely score.
Great score.
Kieran Larkin, that's a great score. That was worked well there now.
Yeah, great score. They're patient.
Kick out now by
James Hoban. Well done, Ronan Byrne. Took that well. Good hands. Into Jack Kendi. We're looking for Jack every time.
Looking for Jack there. And Conor McGrath is staying with him there. Lovely ball from out to over the sideline there.
Total ball again.
Padder just got a hand to it.
Not a great ball in for Brian Byrne. Make him work hard. Two men around him.
Padder Doran went down on the ball. He's fouled. Free out to 10 round. It'll take a few minutes for this to settle down.
To
now,
settle, yeah.
It's nice to see both of them have a pint on the board at the same time. Kieran Larkin on the ball. Kieran gives it back there to Barry Power. Barry is looking for options there, and he has it in Conor McGrath. Conor McGrath to Greg Murphy. Greg Murphy to Kieran Larkin. Good hands there. Kieran Larkin, if he gets a chance, he'll go. If he gets a chance, but there's two men dispossessed him there very well.
No, obviously, no, he's got the guys free, yeah.
He was being held by
Dylan Gorman coming forward. Dylan has gone back now. He'll go back into a sort of a sweeper role. He'll play.
It's a big change from.
Yeah, so they leave a bit of
forward.
Space in for Jack, I'd say.
Kind of playing Jack out on the half more than in on the full forward line. He's back in now. There's a bit of a change here because Jack seems to have gone in to Padder Dorn. Conor McGrath was marking him, but.
Yeah. As you said, it'll take a couple of minutes for this to settle.
There's Dinny Farrell on the ball. Dinny is up through the middle of the field there. He's. To Greg Murphy. Greg Murphy out to Ronan Corn. Now, Ronan is a talent. If he gets half a chance at all, that's going in on top of Evan.
It's gone wide.
It's gone wide.
Yeah. Bit ambitious, sorry, so was. But
yeah. I think it was more a shot for a pint than it was to drop it on top of Evan now.
Yeah. He went for the score, yeah.
Short kick out there, the lads need to wake up.
That's where Dylan is onto it now. Yeah. On to Niall Sherry. Niall Sherry on to Will Dorn. Will Dorn into Staunton. This guy has loads of talent. He'll take him on every time.
Yes, he gets
his
free there.
He's got his free, yeah. He'll do that all day.
Is he going to get a card? He's got a ticket?
I'd say so. Anyway. It was a high tackle.
Yeah.
This will be either Brian Byrne or Jack Kendi will take this. This is in Brian Byrne's range.
Is that a card or a chicken? It's a yellow card for Peter
Early.
No, that's Early.
That's Early. He has to watch himself now.
Really does, yeah. And the game he plays.
Yeah.
You know, a full back off and at this stage is a bit early.
He plays on the edge. On a brain, steady up. No, wide. Unlike him.
Yeah, it was a very casual kind of a kick, but maybe he's so used to slotting those ones over.
He's a great striker of a dead ball, you know.
He just struck it lovely, but just radar off a little bit.
I think he was a bit
casual.
A bit casual there.
The next one won't be as casual.
No, I'd say Jack Kendi will take the next one.
All right, okay. Paul Doyle with the kick out. He's looking around for his options. I'd imagine down on top of Barry Power. Yeah.
Big kick. Will Dorn is up with him. Well done, Will Dorn.
Oh, he picked that off. But anyway.
Did he got away with it?
He got away with it, Jack.
Come on, Jack. Jack is on it.
That's a nice ball from Jack.
Well done, Willie Cannon.
No, that's not a great ball, but.
He looked into space.
Yeah.
Metcalf is on it. or Dylan, Dylan Gorman. To Willie Dorn.
Slow
Jack
bit,
Kendi.
Slow build up here now.
Slow build up, yeah. Looking for the spaces. They'll keep the ball. Jack will keep it all day. Give him a piece of string, that's what he wants on it.
Oh yeah, he's dangerous when he's near the goal though.
Well done, Willie Canavan. They're very patient on it. I'm just looking for them spaces.
What kills this though is if they don't get a score at the end of it,
yeah,
after all
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, I know, I agree with you. It's a waste of time then. Tinryland are just putting everyone behind it. So you have to win them balls on Brian Byrne.
That felt lucky for him there. And
did, yeah. There's a good ball. Over the bar. Jay, that's terrible wide.
Steven. He snapped at it.
Yeah, yeah, he could have took on these men there. There was space inside.
He just snapped at it. Now, after all that, it's a wide.
Yeah. Still 1 point apiece here. And it's yeah, it's fairly even. There's no hold up between the sides. Both teams, I thought they were after settling after getting the early scores, but they're starting to get a bit jittery now, isn't it?
Yeah, I suppose they realise it's the final, and now yeah. This ball is dropping down on top of Mark.
Rowan on the break.
And Greg. Dylan Hanley. But Ronan Horan got into it.
He did, he done well.
He did. No, that was actually Alan Barrett, sorry. Alan Barrett and
yeah.
Doing out to Barry Power. Barry Power into Kieran Larkin. Kieran Larkin is going to take on his man. He gives it to, now it's Ronan Horan.
And his left foot. All left foot.
Yeah, that's all about it. That was well worked, and a very kind of quick movement, you know.
A nice left foot, that Ronan Horan.
But Alan Barrett did well there now when he came out for that ball. Alan is around a long time, he's around the houses a long time, but he was good there. Knew exactly what he was doing.
He won that take, and that ball was turned over and straight in and the score.
Now this is coming out here towards Mark. Mark dropped it down to Kieran Larkin.
Turn him over.
Now that's a great thing from Kieran Larkin. He held on to it enough to for the man to come, and that was Joey Ryan, and then got it away to Greg. Greg up to again Ronan Corn. Ronan Corn into Peeney. Peeney is looking. He's looking at his options. Back again to Greg. Greg Murphy.
Corn is causing a lot of damage in there.
Yeah.
Good turnover. Did he win it? Unlucky.
Dinny Farrell's on to it now. He picked up a dirty ball there and away with him. Dinny led it off to Mark Lawler. Mark Lawler has gotten into the centre. He's going for a run. He's going to take a pot. This is going towards the corner flag.
It's not gone.
It's gone now.
It is now, yeah. I thought Evan Dyle was going to make it.
The Tin Ryland forwards are causing problems up there now.
Yeah, Ronan Corn is alive in there.
He is indeed.
Yeah, to give him the right ball, he'll punish them.
Yeah. Dinny Farrell is picking up the dirty ball there as well. He's doing well. It's coming out towards Dinny Farrell again, this ball. Now he wants to go on first.
Ronan Corn, it's a Tin Ryland ball. That's two kickouts after Tin Ryland after turning over there.
Yeah, but that one just went out over everybody and over the.
Yeah, they got possession though, back off it, you know.
Yeah. Greg Murphy letting in the ball to Evan. Evan, God, what a ball. Evan is through.
Ball. No! Off the post.
Oh, a lucky escape for Tullow there.
Lucky escape.
Yeah. That should have been a goal, Niall.
Evan Dyle done very well there.
Yeah. The fullback is finding it hard with him. The fullback was in the right place. He was right behind him, but he just couldn't handle it.
Evan has a few inches on him.
The
James Holman did well in the goal. He made himself.
Big, he did. Now it was the crossbar that saved it in the end, but it was because you had to keep it away. But anyway, James Tobin with the kick out. Short one again.
Steve Metcalf done it. They sort of have to go short, and Ryland are a bigger team around the middle, you know.
Yeah.
Dylan Gorman Comfort on it.
He dropped that there for.
Fell out of his hands.
Oh, maybe.
After Rowan and Bourne. William Canavan. Well done, William.
William,
no support. He needs support. Well done, William.
Got free there. Free out now.
Free out. Just that was harsh.
He could have got free in there.
Yeah, I thought it was a shoulder in the back. It looked like that from here now.
But anyway, the free is taken and it's Barry Power on the ball. Barry has the ball there and he gives it out to Dinny Farrell. Dinny
with tackle.
Loses the ball.
Along with Lauren.
And then a bad Staunton. Pass goes astray.
Good
and
now ball. It's. TJ Kavanagh is on it.
He has a man outside him, but he didn't spot him.
No. Good score.
He had the confidence to go outside.
Superb score. Yeah. He has striker the ball. He yeah. has that in his locker all day. You know, he just has to get on the ball a bit more, I think.
Yeah, he had a man outside him and he yeah. didn't use him.
He had the confidence to go for it.
He backed himself yeah. and he put it over the bar. 2 points apiece here.
2 points apiece. Nothing between them, Liam.
There is absolutely nothing between them and both teams playing football.
Yeah. Starting to get warm out there now as well.
I just see Pat O'Dorn is after coming out here to the middle of the field.
Okay.
Whatever change that is.
Well done, Stephen Metcalf. On to Jack. Good ball. Into
great
Ronan,
ball.
Ronan Byrne after.
He's going to struggle to get it, though.
Oh, he'll get it, all right. Yeah, he's a gazelle, that lad. He'd run all day.
He's coming back out.
Yeah. They're recycling. They're giving Tin Ryland that time to get back. You know, sure. if they take yeah. on their men, they'll create them gaps inside a bit quicker. Dylan to Dylan. On to TJ Kavanagh again. Dylan Hanley is on it. Back to Dylan Gorham and Comerford. He's looking for Ronan. That's a mark.
Well, no, is the mark being played in
yeah.
this? It must be.
Yeah, he was outside the 45. So that's good thinking with yeah. Brian Byrne now.
Yeah, yeah.
Dylan was just outside the 45 kicking it in, so.
He should slot that over handy enough.
Oh, yeah, all yeah. Day. Yeah, yeah. That's a good confidence booster for him now. He's off the mark now. That's three the taller forwards from play.
Yeah. Paul Doyle with the kick out. Paul with the sun in his eyes, cap on his head. It's coming over this side again towards Pat O'Dorn, Mark Lawler.
Great catch. Unlucky. On the ground, yeah.
Yeah.
He had on the ground.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
Well done, Dylan. He was up there high. Good ball. Ah, they're going to go. They have to be bang on. You have to get them bang on. They're going to skim along the ground and go over the line.
Yeah, that ground is. It's
there's a bit of grease on it
is.
Since this morning. There's a bit of rain there earlier.
That ball seemed to go faster when it hit yeah. the ground. Now, where is this going to drop?
He's going long every time.
It's going over to the far side this time, over to Barry Power. Barry Power.
Ah, Will Dorn is outstanding there.
He's going up. He's
going over him.
He's not trying to catch it with him. He's just blocking
breaking,
it down.
Yeah. He's having a fine game there in the middle of the field. That's a good ball by Will Callum and on to Dylan Gorman. Dylan will move with it. He's looking for Jacko.
Huh? He got him. No, what's wrong?
I don't know. Jacko called the mark. Yeah, he called the mark. And it was knocked over his hands, Liam.
That's all it was, yeah. That's all it was. The referee wasn't too clear.
No, yeah, he was behind it. Like, he didn't get it. No. No, will it come in?
No. Wade. That's not a good kick now from
no,
there.
I'm very surprised with Jack.
Yeah, he's usually very accurate, you know. He's
yeah.
Oh, I can see him doing damage yet now. Yet another kick out from Paul Doyle.
Yeah.
Keep mentioning his name, but it's all kick outs. Yeah. All the play seems to be down this side.
It's all down this end, but there's only a point in it.
Yeah, after all of that.
Yeah. And then Tin Ryland had the best goal chance, you know, so that's not a good kick.
No, and
that's a good ball. Brian Byrne's on it. He has
the
score.
The goal
he has
side.
To make it.
He has the goal side of the man.
Oh,
but
he put no. in. Staunton. Oh, it's terrible.
Yeah, took too much out of it. Yeah, that was good defending there.
Oh, should have been. He should have took
should
his score at the start.
The
he should never yeah. have came back inside. And
he was looking for goal, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a great little chimney
touch
there.
Inside, yeah.
And up to Barry Power. Great work there by Kieran Larkin. Up to Barry has it and back to Gaffney now, Cahill Gaffney. Cathal Gaffney across to Ronan Curran. If Ronan gets enough ball, he'll do damage.
Lee Cathal has to get tighter. He has to get tighter to this guy. This guy is on fire.
Yeah, up to Mark Lawler. Mark is going to burst his way through. And Mark, have a pop at it. Ah, oh, that's gone wide again. No, that's gone over the bar,
that's
Mark.
That's a great score.
That's the kind of play that Tin Rylander
is. They're direct. You know, Tin Rylander are making their chances are counting.
Yeah, and Mark didn't try a big high one like he normally. No. He just slotted over, just economically over the bar.
Yeah, no, it was a great score. First water break there now, Liam.
First water break, okay. Might take one of them myself, though.
Yeah. Nip and tuck. Tin Rylander seem to be more clinical when they're getting their chances. St. Pat's are after having a few wides there.
Yeah, it seems a lot of the play Tullow have it down in the Tin Ryland half, but they're not making you. They're playing around with it over and back and over and back. Being patient, that's fine, and we can see that. But if you don't get a score after a couple of minutes of this patient play, it can have an awful effect on a team, you know.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Go for it, like.
Yeah, Tin Ryland are after. I think Tin Ryland went up the field four times and they're after getting three scores and he wanted to come off the crossbar, you know. So that's how
economical,
clinical they're after being.
You couldn't call it at this stage anyway.
No,
it's too close.
Very tight. I'd say, I think the bench might have a big impact in this game in the last 20 minutes.
Yeah, there's a few to come in for both teams.
Yeah.
And they will be brought in, I know.
Definitely, because it's warm out there as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen that.
The teams are getting back into shape here again, back into position.
Yeah. Kick out from James Tobin to restart it.
Yeah. And he may wait now to get into. That's a little bit quick.
That was very quick.
That's
the
too
referee
quick.
Blew the whistle, though.
He did, and he did it too quick because neither team was back in there.
Caught him going and born for carrying.
No. Oh. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Tin Ryland will take that one.
I
thought when he blew it was going the other way.
I thought it was a free, yeah.
Anyway, back on the ball again here with Kieran Larkin. Kieran is looking up and he gives it out to Peeney. Peeney is looking around for options. Who's around him? Yeah, it's Dinny Farrell. Dinny Farrell, lively.
He's very lively.
Very lively. He's after cutting through the whole of them. And he's giving in to Evan Dial. Evan now.
Steps. Oh, great tackle by Shane Rowan.
The fullback did very well.
Very well by Shane Rowan. He read him very well.
That ball.
Yeah. But here he goes up the field now, and TJ Kavanagh. TJ
is coming across to him.
That's a great ball into Brian Byrne.
It's a full race
Brian,
here.
He got to make it. He has it.
Adam
he is after
there.
Making a brilliant run. Great score with TJ Kavanagh.
Yes.
Superb. He ran the length of the field.
And he took
responsibility on there now. Great ball into Brian Byrne. He backed his run and. Shane Rowan made that score from the fullback.
The fullback there, the dispossession by the fullback.
Superb.
Yeah, that was where that score came from, really. There's a bit of a switch here now, I see. Mark Lawler's gone to the far side. He's been followed there by Dylan Hanley. Mark tips it down to himself. A taller man comes in.
Ronan Byrne.
Ronan Byrne, is it?
Dylan has it. Back to Sherry. Onto Metcalf, Stephen Metcalf. Onto out to TJ Kavanagh again. TJ's getting loads of space down this side now. Well done, Brian Byrne.
No, that was a touch
Craig
on the ground.
Staunton.
But he got away
seemed
with
to be,
it.
Seemed yeah. to be, yeah.
No, in fairness,
Stephen Metcalf on it again. Onto TJ Kavanagh. Patient play again. Will Lauren looking for it. Will run with it. This guy can run with the ball. Onto Jacko. Jacko is being held up.
Yeah.
Well done, Jacko. This could be Brian Byrne off the ground, I'd say, from this
it's a nice range. Distance, all right, but...
Yeah.
No, Jacko was going to do it, isn't he? No,
Brian,
dropping it
Brian
down.
Brian will strike this.
Yeah, he's dropping it down.
It's a bit far for...
No, Jacko.
They don't know what they want.
Not going for it.
Going backwards. I would have backed Brian Byrne there. Hey, Brian Byrne can kick the ball 60 yards off the ground. Will we get a score off? He won't mind. Oh, three in.
I
Jack has had this over himself, I'd say.
Now, had he the ball, or was he coming onto the ball?
He was coming onto it. It looked like it, yeah.
The two of them were coming there. Yeah.
It was and a lazy arm, though.
It was?
Yeah.
But the ball spilled as a result. There's a handy one there now. That makes it 5 points to 3 now.
3-3 to St. Patrick's.
This could come down on a day like today to fitness levels in the last 15 minutes.
Yeah.
That's what it could come down to now. Paul Doyle with the kick out again. I'm hoarse in it. It's dropping down here on top of Kieran Larkin, Stay Greg down. Murphy.
Too many total guys going. Dylan Gorman has it. Dylan will break with it. Well done, Dylan. Done well, he read it. They're lucky.
He read it well.
Three of them went right for it. Yeah.
Yeah, and one Tullam man there was able to.
Ronan Byrne has gone up the far line like a bullet. Look. Jack Hendy. Ah, Jack, that was too lackadaisical.
Yeah. Conor McGrath there now. Conor is only buzzing to get onto this ball. Over to Gaffney. Gaffney up to Peeney Whelan. Peeney looking for ball all day, but he's a little bit far out for where he'd like to have it. Up to Ronan Curran. Ronan Curran is going to turn now. Again, he's too far from
him.
Home. He'd rather be in around the full forward line, but he'll make his way up there.
He will.
Up to Peeney. Peeney is going to let off to Evan. Evan is going to have to chase this one, but he gets it. Yeah,
Shane Ronan is out beside him.
Evan Doyle on the ball now. Into Mark Lawler. Mark is dispossessed. There's four lads for him.
Great backs.
Ah, very well done there. They smothered that out.
Yeah. It's on to James Tobin. On to Lee Kavanagh. Lee Kavanagh will move with this ball. On to Mark Sherry. A little bit behind him. Will Dorn is on it. Back to Lee Kavanagh. Can Raylan are filtering guys back. Craig Staunton. Craig is starting to show well now out for the ball. Jack Hendy is playing inside now, Liam.
Yeah,
he'll take his man on, will he?
That's a good score.
Ah, a superb score. Superb score.
That was his right foot on the right-hand side. That's not an easy thing to do.
That's what he can do.
Like, you'd expect that from the far side, but from this side, it was a great score.
Good ball in by Will Canavan as well.
Yeah, that's very
well. Ball well.
Double scores now,
double
6 points
scores
to three.
Now. Since the water break, St. Patrick's after really coming into it.
Must be something in that water. Kick out again by Paul Doyle. They're breaking down the ball for Tullow in the middle of the field.
Yeah, Tullow winning all the breaks. Dylan is having a fine game there now, a centre forward. He's after winning every breaking ball there since the restart.
But the ball has been broken down, but no Tinryland man is coming onto that breaking ball at all.
That's a great ball. TJ Kavanagh is on it. TJ will put through. Take your score now, TJ. Ah, great score.
Yeah, that's a great score.
Starting to find their players now and their range.
Yeah. And the whole play has moved back down to the Tinryland half of the field as well.
Yeah. Seven-four. Did you time it, Liam?
I didn't.
No.
Trailing
are making a substitute there, Liam.
Yeah, Cormac McGilligott is coming in here.
Hey,
Joey is going off. Yeah, Cormac McGilligott now in the middle of the field.
Big man as well.
He's a big man.
Yeah.
Better known, I think, in rugby circles. But
okay, well, he's on a good rugby man over there as well.
They know each other,
Will, Will Canavan.
Now that's better. Tinryland decided to break it down to themselves.
Metcalf is on. He played for that free.
He did. Yeah. He did. The cuteness there.
Yeah. A bit of experience.
Over to Greg Murphy. Now Greg is looking around for options here. And over to Cormac McGilligott.
Oh, well done, Lee Kavanagh. On to Ronan Byrne. Keep the ball, that's it. Stephen Metcalf. On to Dorn again. Dorn. Onto Sherry.
Now this is going to be Kieran Larkin's ball, and it is Kieran Larkin's ball. Well dispossessed. That's and up to Peeney Whelan. Now Peeney is dangerous. Peeney has the ball there.
Dylan
thought he was going to go for it.
Well done, Dylan.
Too slow.
Great step block, Dylan Gorman.
Too much time to go for that.
That was a great block.
Yeah. He should have gone for the first time.
Keep your ball, TJ. Onto Staunton now again.
Staunton is going the wrong way.
Yeah, he's all right. He keep it. Not much inside. Tinrailin, they're filtering back. Look at that. There's only two Tulla guys inside.
Yeah.
TJ Kavanagh is down injured here at the moment. Be a big loss if he...
No, I'd say he was...
He got slapped.
No, earlier he was here. He was pumping for wind there.
Brian Byrne is on it. He'll take on his man all day now.
Adam Fenley is there with him.
He may do something. On to Jack. Oh, Jacko had cooked. Should have scored that.
Yeah, but Jacko was getting on to a lot of ball.
Yeah, they're starting to link up a bit better there now.
Seven points to three now. It's a while since Tinrailin scored. I'd say Tinrailin are looking forward to the break, to the half time.
Yeah. There's still only 4 points. It's a two score game.
And
but
that goal, which looked like a certainty ahead of him. Paul Dale with the kick out across towards Cormac McGilligan. Now, this will be interesting to see how that goes. They're starting to knock it down to themselves this time. Yeah.
They stayed down for the breaking ball.
Yeah. Now there's Cormac McGilligan on the ball. Cormac, strong chap.
Oh, well, they still dispossessed. Well,
yeah, he dispossessed him, but back again.
He won it back, Mark Lawler.
Oh, great ball out. Howie spotted the man out there. That's Evan. That's gone wide.
Yeah. He had more time on it than he thought.
He could have gone for a run there. Yeah.
Yeah, he had a lot more time on the ball than he thought.
There's new man in the middle of the field now, might make a difference.
He's after sorting out the kickouts anyway, because.
Where's that going?
Dylan Hanley.
It was meant for the other Dylan. Darren
Butter. We haven't seen a whole lot of him. Hold on, Darren. Darren plays the ball simple to TJ Kavanagh. TJ back to Metcalf. Metcalf look up for Brian Byrne inside. Well done, good defending. Will Kahneman is down on it.
Yeah, Greg Murphy is there.
Byrne is on it. He'll cut inside. Oh, great run. A bit soft. Too easy.
Into the hands of Paul Donnelly.
You
Paul
have to make them count.
You do indeed. Paul is straight back out again there to Barry Power. Barry's having a good game. Up to Alan Barrett. Aaron Barrett to Padder Dorn. Padder Dorn up to Dinny. Dinny Farrell. Lovely pick up, but then he slips on the greasy surface.
Right, sure, you try to hold him out there.
Now he's three men, four men around him there. Fifth man is coming in now.
Ronan Curran.
And he was,
again.
Yeah.
They're panicking. They're just snatching at the ball.
There's no need to be kicking from there at all.
Yeah.
Could have gone in again. Peeney was inside him there, looking for the ball.
But like up here. Like Brian Byrne had ample amount of time on that ball. He just had to steady himself, you know.
Yeah. No, he could have. And
yeah.
They're just, both teams are a little bit like that now at the minute.
Look.
Now Dinny Farrell got his hand in there.
They're free in.
Evan is on the ball, but Evan now would be better off dropping that down and going in himself. Yeah. And that's what's happening. Ronan Curran.
I'm moving quick now, look. It's going to be backwards with it.
Yeah, that's not what I meant to do now. But
no,
anyway.
No, I know.
But Ronan is on the ball again.
We'll keep him out there.
Ronan back out to Cormac McGilligan, up to Barry Power. All big lads there. Barry takes a kick, and that's gone to the left
and wide again. Yeah.
That's too many wides, but.
At Tinrailin earlier, at the start, in the first quarter, Tinrailin were working that ball in and they were getting scores. Now they're just shooting that side.
From too far away?
Yeah.
Yeah. But they're getting on more of the ball now than they were 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Definitely are.
Can't be a whole lot left in. 1 minute.
Yeah, we're just at half time.
Ronan Byrne on it. Let's go kick out by James Tobin. Lee Kavanagh, captain for the day. William Canavan, back to Lee. And back to Dylan Gorman Comerford. Looking for TJ Kavanagh. That's a good ball. TJ will keep it. That's on to Hanley. Hanley in move. He just has to move if he wants to.
He's been held up. Yeah.
It's a good ball into William Dorn. Will Dorn looking for Kendi. They're double marking him in there now.
Yeah, and it worked that time.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and there's Conor McGrath there now on the ball. Hand pass across to Greg Murphy. Greg Murphy, number 22, to Adam Fenley. Adam Fenley, young fella there, flying up along the far side. He has Evan Dial to his right.
He's
going straight through, nobody coming to him. He gives it to Ronan Curran. He found his man. Ronan is looking around. If he spots Peeney, Peeney is on his left. Peeney is available. But he's going back at himself to Mark Lawler. Mark then finds Peeney. And back to Kieran Larkin. I don't know where that was to go, but it's a free anyway.
No, goal kick. It's up. Is it? No, you give a free.
Free, yeah. He had his hand up, but okay. I don't know what the free was for, whether there was a holding or something there that I missed, but he's given a free in now. Now, this will be interesting because
this goes over, then he leaves
one score
again.
Between them, which is, I know it's a goal, but it would be 3 points, but still, after all of that, like,
has to go over the bar first.
Peeney is usually accurate now, so see how he gets on with this one.
Struck it well.
Oh! That was so close to being in the corner.
Oh,
that could have been in the corner.
It could have been.
It came off the post.
It looked like it was
right
going to the corner.
Yeah. Half-time here at Dr. Cullen Park, 7 points
to three.
Tullow will be the happier team now, let's say.
They will, Liam, yeah. I'd say they could be actually a bit disappointed with, like, they had a few chances there that, you know, easy enough chances that you'd be expecting Jack Kennedy to tap them over and Brian Byrne. But still,
Jack is working hard, though.
They're going in 4 points up at half-time in a county final, you'd be happy, yeah.
You would, yeah.
Yeah.
You would, yeah.
Yeah.
Some of us will drift apart while others stay together. Some will step in from the rain while others face the weather. Some will take the last breath while others breathe new life. Though they're standing on our necks, we're still the will to fight. Just cause things are different don't mean anything has changed. And I know the world's on fire, but there's beauty in the flame. And we don't know how much longer, but we know we're gonna come back strong. We'll lose ourselves while others rediscover. The love is in the innocence of baby to its mother. The sun will grasp it in the hands while others lose control. Yeah, we gotta leave our fingerprints so that the future knows. Different don't mean anything has changed. And though the world's on fire, there's a beauty in the flame. And we don't know how much longer, but we know we're gonna come back stronger. Oh.
think about me now and who I could have been. And then I picture all the perfect that we lived, till I cut the strings on your tiny violin. My mind's got a mind of its own right now, and it makes me hate me. I'll explode like a dynamite if I can't decide, baby.
Kenny, who's have to catch me for this.
He's up at the back of the stand there.
Laughing at me. Yeah, so I tell you, Liam, there's like the wind is no factor. Like, you look at the flags there, they're down in the...
And the sun has gone down now, there's no... Yeah, it was like, in the rise there for a little bit, but it's gone now.
It's perfect conditions for
absolutely
for
perfect. A goal could change this either way.
Absolutely.
Tullow got a goal, I'd say.
Yeah, they could run away with it, yeah.
And if Tinrailan got a goal, and they're back into it, and...
Yeah.
Well, they're not gone over with points either.
No, absolutely.
It's one of those games that a goal could really change it. The low scoring can be like that. What does this mean for Tullow to win this? Is it... Do they go
intermediate?
Yeah,
play intermediate championship in 2021 then.
Yeah.
Yeah. I said Tinrailan would too. Tinrailan
would go intermediate.
Yeah,
and
yeah. The winner,
and
the winners go. The winners go.
Okay.
Up, yeah.
No matter what, like.
No matter what. TJ Kavanagh on the ball into Jacko. Jacko is on it.
He's turning again.
On. He'll come back in. He's looking for a free. That's a free.
He got a free.
Oh God! How did he not get a free there? He got. That was shocking this season, maybe.
Yeah, that's a free.
That's a free.
All day long, that's a free. There's a great ball to Peeney. And Peeney's turned there down to Mark Lawler. Mark Lawler on the ball with Dylan Hanley.
Busting through.
He's gone past Dylan Hanley there. He's out to Ronan Corn. Now, Mark stays going. No. Ball across to Peeney to the far side.
Switching it. He made him do a little bit of work onto it.
He did. That gave the opportunity for lads to come back.
Yeah. Oh,
where's this going?
Going backwards with it.
To Greg. Greg now, if he sees McGilligott. McGilligott is going through, big, strong
steps.
Man.
Steps.
He's not going to get through
steps,
there.
No, good defence, but...
Now, is that over the bar?
It's wide.
It's wide.
Yeah. I don't know how Jack Kennedy didn't get a free there.
There must have been someone blocking his view for
there
that one.
There must have been.
They're the breaks you have to take, though.
There, yeah.
They go the other way as well. No.
That's a taller ball.
Yeah, they come off the foot of Dinny Farrell.
Off the foot of Dinny Farrell, yeah. Will Kahneman is on it. Into Sherry. The Monaghan man. He only married recently.
Or originally from Monaghan?
I mean, yeah, he got married last week, a week before there.
Okay.
Willie Kahneman on the ball.
Good man, Willie.
Great ball.
Absolutely inch perfect into the chest of number 7.
Brian Byrne. Brian gets a yard, he'll pop it. Jack is on it. Staunton. TJ Kavanagh. Ronan Byrne. Ah, he snatched at that, he pulled it to the left
and
wide.
No lead. He had more time than he realised.
Yeah. Panicking.
So you have, he's a Monaghan man and we have a forward there. His people are from Cavan, Adam
right.
Barrett. Yeah.
Northern influence.
And Mark's granddad would be from Cavan as well, played county football with Cavan.
Okay.
So his grandfather did. So there's a Cavan influence there as well. A border county job.
Yeah.
I think there's a Kerry connection here with this man here.
Willie Hanneman's on that.
Oh, he missed it.
Dorn on it.
He's laughing as he gets up off the ground.
He got away with it. Stephen Metcalf. Stephen's playing well there today now in the middle. Loads are running over him. He's going up through the middle. He gets bottled up if he doesn't use it. Staunton. Good ball.
This lad is lively, Staunton.
Yeah, he's a good footballer. Onto Dempsey, or Kavanagh. Wide again, yeah.
Must be something with that goal up there.
Yeah.
If Tullow were finishing clinically, this game would be over.
Be over, yeah. They're not. They're leaving Tinryland, innit?
They are. And you know, it'll come down then to the last 15 minutes on the bench. And
lucky old goal there, knowing nothing can happen.
Paul has put away the hat. The cap is gone, definitely.
Yeah.
He's going to drop this over to the far side. Oh, it didn't
straight go. Straight up the middle again.
Yeah. And it's
Canavan's on it.
Canavan. Oh, Cormac McGalligan looked at it, watched it, and it came to him. Up to Alan Barrett.
It's dangerous.
Over his head.
There's now, danger on here. Tonight will have a run on. Evan Doyle. Barrett. That's a penalty.
It's a penalty. It has to be a penalty.
It has to be, yeah.
Now, Evan Doyle, Alan Barrett did very well there.
Yeah.
I felt if Evan had to stay going, he had a good chance himself. But he did the right thing. He gave it to young Curran, who's playing really well.
Yeah,
course,
there was no Lee Kavanagh pulled the jersey off him. There was no need for it.
No need, that's it.
He still
him.
Had to get away the kick. Yeah. He was taking a chance of getting himself sent off there. You know?
Did he get a card? I don't think so.
He's consulting now with the umpire.
I think he's more watching to see where it's been placed, is he?
Who's taking this for tonight?
Peeney. Yeah, Peeney.
And James Tobin.
Good man, Peeney.
Over the bar.
Over the bar. Peeney.
He went for the roof of the net, so he did.
And it went over. At least it went over. Then it didn't go wide. Yeah. And it's a score anyway.
Yeah. That's a let off.
It is a let off. That's two kind of
goal chances Tinryland had. Yeah.
Now Cormac McGilligan is coming on to this again. This chap is doing very well
He's made a big difference since he came into the game.
Absolutely has, yeah. And there's a great ball out to Ronan Curran, but Ronan takes the mark. But the jersey again is being pulled off him.
Lee Kavanagh, he needs to get tighter to him.
Back out to Alan Barrett.
He gave a free. He gave a free from the earlier.
Yeah, and he was just given the advantage and it didn't work out. And now Ronan Curran is a good player.
Fine footballer. He'd be very close to the Ireland senior team, would he?
He would. He would. He'd have to be. There's a few of them there now, and he'd be one of them.
Very lively.
He's a good football brain.
Oh yeah, no, he's more dangerous inside than he is out the field. You know?
Yeah, I'd rather see him in around there now. Yeah. And
7-4.
Peeney with the kick. It's over. Near the stand side.
Struck it well.
But.
Short.
But punched over the bar.
Yeah, he got the score off it.
That was Evan.
Evan Doyle. Yeah.
It was going to the far side to go wide, and Evan got his fist to it.
Yeah.
Dropping short, maybe, and he got his fist to it. Now.
St. Raylan coming back into it.
There's two scores without reply.
Yeah.
But it's going over towards Mark Lawler. I don't know, it's a bit silly kicking him over towards there for
size. Are all big men there, you know, they want to be using them kickouts better.
Mark is a foot over Dylan there. There's a great catch by Evan Dyle.
He didn't call the mark either.
He didn't?
No.
If that goes over, which it won't, it's coming down on top of. So this is a lottery ball now. Yeah, and
Lee Kavanagh.
Free out.
Oh. Darren Butler, he's on the knife edge there. He went out, he led with the elbow.
He did.
He was lucky.
It was ignored.
He was very lucky.
Yeah. Now, there's a kind of a consolation free, I'd say, for what happened inside. Because there was very little in that there now.
Yeah.
Very little in that.
Tuller's coming in there now.
Is this him?
There's Tudor coming in, going into the full forward lane, it's it.
Who's going out?
Going on, Screw O'Neill is coming in, it's right, Alan O'Neill. Alan will be he'll steady the ship in the back lane now.
Two substitutions on these.
Brian Byrne is coming off, and and Alan O'Neill is in for Carrick Murphy is not playing.
No.
Darren Butler.
Darren Butler?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say they spotted what happened there a minute ago and it, yeah.
Yeah.
Now we're off again. And it's Pat O'Doran on the ball out to Barry. Barry is dropping it in here on top of Alan Barrett.
There's Alan O'Neill on it straight away. Great man to read the game. Dylan Gorman coming for it on it. Out to Hanley. Or Dorn. Jeez, that's a 50-50 ball there now.
And that was back to Tim.
It was a bad pass. He could have went back inside with that, you know.
I think he was watching the man.
Yeah.
Dinny Farrell. Pat O'Doran. Oh no, sorry, not Dinny Farrell. Dinny Farrell is on a note. It was Conor McGrath the first time. There's Kieran Larkin. He's going to get bottled up into Greg. Jesse did well, Greg, to win that back between two lads. Out to Carm up McGilligate. Back to Conor McGrath. Conor McGrath down to Peeney. Peeney's going to have to chase this one to keep it in play, and he does just that. Out near the corner flag. Back out to Conor McGrath. Conor McGrath took it up. Nice ball. And he gives it to McGilligate. Oh, McGilligate into Mark Lawler. Mark Lawler was blocked. And it goes out for a 45.
Five, yeah.
That's good bit of play there now.
Kinraylander are, after coming out alive since half time.
Yeah, whatever was said at half time seems to have made a difference.
They're playing all the football here now. John Kenny running into the field. Another Tullow legend. He'd still be able to play out there today if he wanted to.
Yeah. That man got hurt coming across Cormac McGilligate there.
Shane Rowan.
That man is trying hard all day.
Yeah, he's doing well there. It's a good battle between himself and Evan Doyle.
Yeah, Peeney with the free, drops it in short. Evan Doyle is in a foot chase there with
Lee Kavanagh.
Lee goes down on the ball
on the ground there now.
And then he...
Three in.
Yeah, that was a silly kind of a free to give away there.
Yeah. He fell on the ball, I think.
He did, and then he put out the hand to...
Yeah. He would have won his free if he had bent down and got, you know.
He would have.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he was kind of playing for a little bit. Ronan Curran with the free now. Is Ronan going to go?
Oh, he'll go for this, yeah. Left footer. Left footer all day. Let's leave a point between them.
Ah, that's a great free.
Great score.
Now, there's
one,
three scores without reply.
Yeah. It's the kickouts. Tinraylan are after turning over every single kickout since half time.
Yeah, they're not trying to catch them now. They're cutting back down to themselves.
Yeah.
Like, there we go.
Well done, Will Dorn.
Well, now he did well. He had four lads around him. And this man doesn't have the legs, but he knows what to do with
that's
it.
That's a terrible pass.
Yeah, he didn't want to go with it. Jack Kennedy was gone. He's tiring a little bit.
Yeah,
he's given it everything.
Yeah, they may bring Jack Kennedy out the field, I think.
There's a great ball into Kieran Larkin. Over to Barry Power. Barry Power is going to have a pot of this. No, Barry.
Hold on, Jim Bob. Jim Bob Tobin. Lee Kavanagh. Lee Kavanagh, TJ. Very quiet in the second half.
Yeah.
It's the first time he's been on the ball.
No.
Mark Staunton, great catch.
Great catch. Tuller's
gone.
Forward.
No one in.
He didn't
well
spot the man.
TJ is on it. Matt Tuller, he's off. This is how he's going up. Penalty! Had to be a penalty.
Oh, it's a free outside the penalty area, is it?
I don't know about that. It's a black card, if anything, as well.
It would be a black card, in all the terms. But he was outside when he was fouled.
Sure, it was a definite goal chance.
But that rule is not.
It is, yeah. That should be implemented. I don't know. Yeah, because they're going on this year's rules.
On this year's rules?
Yeah.
Rather than last the competition
year,
rules?
Yeah, yeah.
Right, okay.
So there was a definite goal chance, like.
Now, he's taken out a card here. What's the card for? Oh. To write in the score, I think, is it? That's it.
Score. That puts two between. What?
You got deducted one there instead of added one. Yeah, it's okay now, it's gone up.
Was it level? No, I think there's 2 points in it, yeah?
I think Tin Ryland might have got a score there that they shouldn't have got.
Yeah, 8-6, that's it, yeah.
Yeah, it's 8 points to 6, yeah, would be the proper score.
Yeah. That's Tullow's first score of the second half.
After how many minutes? I didn't take the time.
I didn't take it again either myself.
There's a great kick out there. And it's again Tin Ryland.
Tin Ryland are all over the middle of the field, all over them breaks.
Yeah.
They're going to route one.
Route one into Evan Doyle.
Let's go, Will.
Evan Doyle taps it down for Ronan Corn. Ronan Corn kicks it.
That's
and over the bar.
He's a danger, man.
He is, and the man that's on him there is standing off
too loose.
Too
loose.
Number six. No.
Number four, Lee Kavanagh.
It was number six that was standing off in that time now.
Yeah.
Now, this is Conor Brennan is coming in. I expected this to happen.
Okay.
Who's going off? Few changes here now.
All right.
Pater Dorn, who was on a yellow, has gone off. There's Conor Brennan in already.
Okay. Alan O'Neill. Alan has done well since he came in there. It's a few vital interceptions you have to make.
That's a vital one there,
though. Yeah.
Conor Brennan is a big man there, number 20, that came in.
Kavanagh is on it again. Staunton again. Well, just that is
now,
good.
Now, there's a man gone running here, number
he's
7.
He's going up the middle with it every time. Like, they're getting bottled up the middle, you know.
Now, there's a free
there's
here.
Tuller, there's Tuller go. Will he take him on? Absolutely, all day. Pop it over, Jacko. Wide.
Now, he has to come back to deal with an incident back here now. No, it was straight in front of Billy Fanning. I didn't, but
I didn't see it. I was following the play, Liam, so I didn't.
But the man seemed to have been taken out, but yeah, there's a man getting a card there now, but I'm not sure who's getting it. Could be Peeney, actually. But all eyes on the ball there, I'd say, was what happened, and there was a collision.
Yeah, the linesman is coming in here. 8-7, still only the one between them.
Yeah, he's up, and Mick Keogh did the magic on him there.
That's John Kenny.
John Kenny,
yeah.
Mick could do the magic too.
That's right, yeah.
Now, where's this going?
Straight. Sherry is on it. Niall Sherry.
Well
behind Tuller.
Yeah, this man is lively, and if he stays ahead of Tuller, as you call him, that's the only way he's going to be... win that. Now the ball is with Kieran Larkin coming down through the middle. He's looking for to see who's around him. He's went around Jacko and he lets it off there to Ronan Corn.
This league having has to get tighter to this man. This man is causing all the damage
to Mark Lawler, finding each other there. The two lads know each other well. Down to Conor Brennan, big strong man, let off a lovely ball there to Peeney has
him
now.
Ronan Byrne.
back to Conor Brennan.
Will he try to get the shot off?
Conor Brennan back to Mark Lawler.
Dropping over.
Oh, that's
over
a
the
good
bar.
Score.
Great score.
That's a great score.
Superb score.
Or was it Evan? I don't know which of them it was. It was Evan, actually, I think.
Yeah, it was a great score. Level again now.
The two blondie heads out there mixing the two of them up. Is it water break?
Water break now, yeah.
Now what's the score? It's all
level
even now.
Level now.
Now it'll come down to this last 15 minutes. That's really where it'll come down to fitness and...
Yeah.
Mental resolve and everything because it's so even. Tin Ryland are in a better place than they were at half time.
Absolutely.
Not just on the scoreboard.
No, the momentum is with them.
Yeah.
The momentum is with them, Liam. But like, after kicking five scores to Tullow's one.
Yeah, and I see Cormac McGilligott has really come into the game.
Yeah, they're after winning a lot of the breaks around the middle of the field.
Evan is more involved in the game now as well. And Ronan Curran.
That's because they're turning over that ball, yeah.
More ball going down there.
Yeah.
Don't know what happened to Padder now. He's a lost full back. I know he was on a card, and Padder has been around a while, so
yeah.
Maybe just the fresh full back. I think Cahill Gaffney has gone in full back.
I'd say the card was the big reason.
Maybe.
Yeah, yeah.
And Cahill is a good full back too. Now it's all to play for. After all this time, it's...
Yeah.
Kick out by...
James Tobin.
Going over there towards the far side.
Metcalf. Sherry is under again.
He tapped it down on it.
Neil Sherry driving out with the ball. Onto Stephen Metcalf. Stephen onto Dylan Gorman. Dylan held up there.
Connor Brennan held him up there. Big strong Connor. He wasn't Metcalf. Letting him pass.
Just way behind Neil Sherry. Space. Will Dorn is in the middle if he's looking for him.
Oh, Connor Brennan did well there. He got his hand to it, but I'd say it's gone over the. No,
he kept it in play.
Well, yeah. Well, Conor Brennan came across there and the man pulled back. So. Conor McGrath out to Greg Murphy. Greg Butcher House. There's a man coming up behind you.
Craig Saunton.
Kieran Larkin has it now and he's going off. Gives it to Gaffney.
Ball is running.
He's getting away from him. He got the dough. And he lets it down to Ronan Curran. Ronan has the beating of his man all day.
Didn't hold him up.
That's a great ball.
Makes space.
Down to Gaffney, except...
Oh, sorry, staying in.
Staying in, is it? Yeah. James was a great ball by Barry Power. And it's...
Quite a score.
Oh, that's some score.
Oh, that's unbelievable score.
If I had that in the senior game here, we'd be...
That's unbelievable.
We'd be applauding it. That was called Gaffney at his best now.
Yeah.
From full back, he came all the way down there to take the return pass and put it over the bar.
That was a great score.
Now, it was a great pass by Barry Power across to him in the first place. Now the ball is coming to kick out.
Kick outs are going wrong.
Yeah, that's what you get now when you get at this stage of the game.
Panic.
A little bit. John Hickey is the flag up. Oh, there's a sub coming in. 20.
Oh, Jamie Ansborough. Jamie Ansborough. Ron Burns coming off here.
I thought he was coming off.
Yeah.
There's a great kick by Cormac McKelly, get in on top of Peeney Whelan, and Peeney Whelan turns and Peeney Whelan puts it over the bar.
Two in for Tim Whelan now.
Now the momentum has swung completely.
Completely. Completely.
It's 10 points to 8 now for Tim Whelan.
Yeah.
But there's a good ball in. Peeney came on to it over the bar. Simple football.
The kick out, he has to be a bit quicker with them.
Tim Ryland
are just...
Tim Ryland are tightening up on all the...
Look, God, this Tim Ryland ball again. He's kicking straight out to the Tim Ryland legs.
But he has no options. There's nobody kind of moving for him. And the short one is not available anymore. Over to Barry Power. Barry is playing around with it there now, but I don't like this playing around. Go for it. Now, surely that's a free.
He gave it out. He's on the same in the first half. Yeah.
He did.
Yeah.
That surely is a free where Adam puts his hand around his waist and pulls him to the ground. And they're asking why.
This is too slow, Lee Kavanagh. He may have moved. Look, he's letting Tim Ryland get back in positions now. And then going backwards.
You have to go backwards.
That ball
though.
Should have been gone in.
Yeah.
You're actually killing your forward line with no quick ball going in.
I just noticed some of the Tuller lads that were making themselves available in the first half.
They're gone over it.
They're not making themselves
available. No, you're right there, Liam.
Now there's a turnover.
Well done, TJ.
Now,
come on, Craig, take him on. Don't get the ball into the hands and take him on.
This man is available all the time.
Yeah, he's playing well. Oh, terrible ball. Terrible, terrible kick.
Yeah, but he had very few options again.
No.
Do you know? Is Jacko, where's Jacko?
He hasn't touched the ball in the second half, Liam.
Why?
He's been playing. He's been brought out the field now. Yeah.
Young McGrath's sticking with him there, like a flea on a dog.
He hasn't gone to it at all.
Paul Doyle with the kick out. 10 points to 8 to Tin Ryland. The kick out goes towards the middle of the field. Now this is coming down on top of Peeney. If he,
Peeney
read that well. He absolutely read it well into Dinny Farrell. Dinny Farrell is going like a train on his outside. Dinny Farrell is going through. Dinny Farrell is kicking.
Good save.
Good save by the goalie.
Well done,
that
Jim
is
Bob.
A great save. That could have been game set and match.
Yeah, he should have popped it over the bar.
He should have, and it would have been
met three in it.
Yeah. Oh, there's a free, but he's given the advantage. Yeah, that's okay. And Tulloch coming away with it there, yeah.
And Tulloch's on it. Oh, Willie Canavan is on it. No one inside, though. 50-50 ball, Will. Ah, not good enough.
No, that was a poor ball.
That was
between
a terrible ball.
Two Tin Riley men there.
Terrible ball in. Should have kept it, like, you know.
Dinny, you have to go for that.
Young Metcalf
Dinny was waiting for it and it didn't come to him because...
Look up, if he looks up the line, Will Canavan is free.
No.
No one with him. There's Jack, he's on and out. That's a good ball.
Yeah,
good score, TJ Kavanagh. Back to one in it. This could
one
go the whole way.
This could go to the wire.
Yeah.
What happens if it's a draw today?
Extra time, no penalties.
Extra,
there's a replay Tuesday night, I think.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, Paul Dyle needs to look here. Cormac McGilligan and Barry Power are looking for it here.
Size of these two boys this side.
And the must kick it straight out to a Tulloch man.
Oh, gee, he may move with it. It's wide open for him. May I lay it off now? Tuller's on it. Yes, way over Tulloch. Jack Kennedy,
yeah. That came from a very poor kick out.
Kick out, yeah.
I was just saying, if you have to look over here, the lads were screaming for it. And he kicks it straight out to a Tulloch man.
Yeah. In fairness, the boys done well, TJ Kavanagh done well, and Owen O'Toole.
Yeah, dead out of momentum and swing.
Yeah.
And this is the time for it to be swinging.
Yeah. 1-9-10, two in it again. Well, Tin Ryland had the chance up here.
That could have been a goal up here, and instead of that, it's a goal down the other end.
That's got Craig Staunton and Will Dorn.
That was a push.
And stay down now, game management. It was that? It was shoulder in the back though. It was not really to it, you know. He just
there was no hurt
he was
there.
Going, he was going down on the ball, and he just So he's taking a breather.
There's a swing now in the game.
Yeah, I didn't see it coming, did you?
No, I didn't. And with when Dinny was going through down here and he kicked it, as you say, had that gone over the bar and ended?
I thought he was just going to tap it over and that put 3 points in it.
Yeah,
he went for the juggler and
then a poor kick out up here because.
Yeah.
The calamity and bang, a goal. And well taken goal now by Jack. In fairness to him, well taken goal.
I thought he should have been brought out a bit more get on the game. He's very fit like, and the game was sort of bypassing him there, wasn't it?
Because the middle
were winning the middle of the field.
Yeah, but you see what happens then when he is left inside, you see? The one
that's the thing as well,
that's the chance you're taking.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
He gets that and he takes it.
Yeah, Will Dorn took a heavy hit there. Hopefully he'll be okay. Staunton is on. This chap has done very well, hasn't he?
He's a workhorse.
There's the big screw gone with the ball. Look, Jack is on it again. Is it over? It is.
Yeah, that's a great score.
Great score, Jack Kennedy. That's 1-5 for Jack.
Yeah. He's doing well. He needs to be closely marked now. Now, Barry Power's calling for this ball again down on this side here. He's a foot taller than your man. Oh, he kicks it back to
straight
the again.
Man same again, Liam, yeah.
That is so stupid.
All you do is get down on the ball, keep it. Tulloch need to be a bit clever now and just keep the ball. Nothing stupid. Yes, that was hard. It wasn't a free.
Hard to see how it was.
Well done, Tuller. Oh, straight to a Tin Ryland man.
Now they're coming out. Now they need all break out.
The space is up
here.
There's a few
walking out where they need to be running out. Come on.
Staunton again. He's. But that's where you foul him. That's. He gave the boys a chance to get back.
Where's Evan? Evan needs to get back up in today. He's out in the middle of the field now, but he needs to go back up into the forward line. Dinny on the ball now. Dinny rounds his man. Dinny is gone.
On Dylan, get the block in.
He lets off the ball into Alan Barrett. Alan Barrett is trying to get under this.
Chadrack is on it. James Holman.
That's a free out.
Cheers, no, he didn't give it.
He didn't give it, but it's coming out anyway.
There's Jack back now. He's
look where he
work.
Is now. Yeah. He's working.
Look up, keep the ball. That's all you have to do now. Ransborough making a run up the line. Alan O'Neill. Alan has really steadied the ship since he came in.
Yeah, there's.
That's Metcalf. He's been outstanding today. A young lad. Will Dorn.
Keep ball now for
that's
the next
it.
Drive.
That's all I have to do. I don't know what's left in it, Liam, do you?
I don't know what time is left.
No. There couldn't be a whole lot in it.
There's a goal in it.
No, yeah, that's a terrible ball to be given it someone.
No, McGilligan. Ah, that's too lucky, casual. Lucky. Casual.
Well done. TJ's on it. Pooler has it. Pooler.
Now he's bursting his way through.
Wide.
And he puts it wide.
I thought it was a free anyway.
Yeah, he was looking for the free, but I think with his head down, he was.
This is a good young lad coming in now, David. Lovely left foot on him.
Who's he going in instead of
TJ Kavanagh? TJ clocked up 4 points from play. He had a great first half.
Yeah.
You know.
Ah, yeah.
And
no,
he was influential in that goal as well. He won the ball for the kick out and he carried it. And, you know, you have to run these legs off there.
In fairness, he was gifted the ball for the kick out.
Absolutely, yeah.
But he's worked hard. He's worked hard all day. Kick out from Paul Dyle. Cross to the far side again.
That's better from Metcalf. He's really playing well there now in the last few minutes. Yeah, Binsky has gone free. Look, if he looks up, Toller's on it. That's it.
That's a great call.
Jack O'Kennedy again.
Jack O'Kennedy to the other Army man O'Toole.
Yeah.
Bang, in the back of the net.
Yeah. Delighted for Tooler now. Delighted for him.
Yeah, I know. He's
after
the
well since he came in.
Yeah, I know, and he's playing well.
I told you that. He'll have 20 good minutes in him.
He's a clever fella.
Yeah. He's unlucky like a couple of times. He missed that.
Now that's McCormick. McElligott grabbed the ball, but he dropped it. Mark Lawler picked it up.
So they're slowing it down a bit.
It's Lahint Evan Doyle. Evan is going for this one now. There's still a goal in Evan.
Oh, Alan.
Evan over the bar.
Point.
That's a good score from Evan, but if Evan gets half a chance. But I think it might be too late at this stage now. There's 29 minutes gone.
Is there?
Dylan Hanley is coming off.
Niall Gann is on for Dylan Hanley. Another good young guy. He's like. Well, you're talking now the guts of 60% that taller team is all in 19 years of age.
Yeah, well, you see, that makes for the future.
Absolutely, and that's what we have to do, you know.
Yeah, like it's Shane O'Neill is in there now for Tin Ryan.
Shane,
and he's
Shane
the box
is
in the
around a long time as well.
He is. No, he hasn't been around lately, but
right.
He was with his team. There's Ronan Corn. Ronan is all bottled up there.
That's good defence. He gave a free in.
He did, but.
There can't be a whole lot left in injury time, I'd say, Liam, is there?
No, probably the time for the substitutions now will be added to
it. Maybe a couple of minutes, I'd say,
yeah.
Yeah. It was flowing enough, wasn't it?
It was a good game. There was no hassle at all. I'd say for the percentage of play, Tolo, it's probably a fair result.
It means a lot to the club now if we can get back up into intermediate, you know, especially with such a young team. 3 minutes.
Try and keep them together. And you know,
that's what happened is we won the intermediate in 2005 and I was talking to John Kenny this morning. 2 years after that, 17 lads weren't playing football, you know, and we were senior at that stage.
You see, lose too many. There's a good kick
around the house.
Screw
has it. Great hands, hasn't he?
Yeah, you came out with that one.
Yeah, he's been brilliant since he came in.
It's a little bit dangerous playing around with it there.
Absolutely, you get out. Oh, Shane Rowan. That's it. Switch it to the far side of the field. There's loads of lads on it. Oh, that's terrible that ball. That's up into the stand.
Yeah. Shane O'Neill now.
Just kicking it back to them, you know.
If Shane kicks it in, Evan is screaming for it inside.
Absolutely. Alan O'Neill had to sprint back there now to... He's gone across the field with it.
Back to Kieran Larkin to Mark Lawler.
I thought they would have put it in on top of the house.
Greg needs to kick it now out to Shane O'Neill. Shane O'Neill will do the right thing, in on top of everybody.
There
could be someone get a fist to this. Yeah.
It's over the bar.
Over the bar.
4 points in it.
4 points in it.
4 points in it with a minute to go.
I see Keane Nicol gone in there, number 19 for Tinryland. That wasn't announced. I don't know who's gone off. Number 19, Keane Nicol.
Okay. No, they didn't say, actually. The PA system hasn't
announced that.
And I didn't see it myself. There's James Tobin with the kick out. A minute left on the clock. Tuller just need to keep the ball now. That's
won't
shocking.
Keep it doing
kick
that.
Out again. He's just giving the ball back to Tinryland. If Tinryland get a goal in the next, it's only a point
Mark
in
is
it.
Mark is screaming for it there, Mark Lawler.
That's not the ball he was looking for.
But Peeney, in fairness to him.
It's gone now.
No, it's gone.
Lucky.
Peeney got his hand to it, but couldn't hold on to it.
That instead of just kicking the ball, you know, keeping the ball.
Yeah.
Kicked out over sideline. There must be a little breeze.
It's some coming way across it's the field.
Because this goal seems to be easier goal than scoring. Like it was the same in the first
half.
The score is easier, didn't it?
They did, and yeah. But
okay.
We're
15 seconds
left.
And Will Kahneman is up. Will Dorn is up. None of them win it.
Shane O'Neill has it. And he kicks the high one in, which is...
Alan O'Neill.
Dylan
Gorman with the ball.
They're cleaning up well.
That's
in
it,
there
Niall Gann. Alan O'Neill is after really steadying the ship since he came in. He's after keeping Evan Dial out of it.
He is, yeah.
You know, as Evan was causing...
He's a marked man there.
Oh, he was causing fierce trouble. That's the ball into Saunton again. He's after running his legs off, this chap, all day. Into Tuller. Has he got one burst left in him? Great ball, Tuller. Orbinski, this lad will pop it over if he can. Yeah, he's clever. Out to Ansborough. Kahneman is on it. Will Dorn. Tuller happy just to keep the ball in.
Yeah.
They're running down the clock.
You're going to have to pick a man of a match probably at some stage as well.
Yeah. Who do you think?
It'd have to be Jacko.
Jacko or
number 14.
Staunton, yes. Yeah. Staunton was very good.
I suppose Jacko scored
1-5.
Yeah, it's hard to pass him then.
It's hard to pass him, you know.
And he's clever play there, and his kicking of the ball there is second to none.
You know,
this is over.
That's it. We're back to intermediate.
Yeah, congratulations.
Great game, Liam. It means an awful lot to these boys.
And a lot of these lads for Tinryland will be playing senior, I'd say, this
of course,
year. You know?
That's
the consolation for them.
Yeah. You see the crowds there from Tully. It means an awful lot to a town.
It does mean,
it'll give it a real big lift, you know.
It means a lot to football in the county.
Yeah.
That you can do this and bring it to another level. And surely, you know, something kind of will come out of it down the road. That
hopefully,
they won a Junior A final into intermediate. Build on that and see what happens.
Yeah, the last time we won the Junior A was 98. We went down in 97 from back to Junior. We bounced back the year in 98. And we went to intermediate semi-final the following year. And the intermediate final got betting in 0-0. And we won it in 0-1.
Yeah, so...
You know, so within 3 years we were back senior and in two intermediate finals, so...
Look at it's great for the club.
Yeah,
no doubt
that is.
And you know, on the overall play, Tuller were the better team here today. Few mistakes.
They let Tinryland back into it in that third quarter. That third quarter, Tinryland put it up to them.
That had been the goal. If I know, I keep saying if, but if it was the goal, that changed to a goal on the other side within a minute. You know? That was the turning point of the game.
Yeah, it was actually.
Yeah,
because that was put them 3 points. Tuller went up the field and got the
absolutely
got the goal.
You know, Tinryland would be disappointed, but at the same time. You know, it was Tullow's day, and it is Tullow's day, and it probably means more to Tullow as a club.
It would. Like you see all the young people there now, looking at the game, and like that's what they're going to want to do. Is
you're
get
competing
up
with other sports in Tullow, and it's nice to see Gaelic football coming onto another level. You know,
and I just going to give a shout out there to to Mick Sam Comfort, Frank Wallace and Abby Quigley. They're in the selectors, and them boys are after sticking with these guys, you know, and backing themselves with the young lads.
Oh yeah, and you know, equally there we have just looking down there at Peeney and Niall Barrett and JP and the lads, they've kept this team together for Tin Ryland and kept them as a unit together there, even though, you know, we had COVID and with the difficulties.
Hard, yeah.
And you'd have lads going here, there and everywhere.
Yeah.
But they kept this squad together as much as they could. And,
right. You know, fair play, like, for your second team to be in a final and put it up to to us. Like, it was a great, good game of football.
Absolutely. And not as
goals win games, and that's
in Hurland, is not a dirty stroke in it.
No. And like we were just talking there in the first half, Tin Ryland had their goal chances, Liam,
they
didn't take them.
Yes,
and Tolo had their goal chances and took the goal chances. Yeah,
that's the difference. That's the difference.
That's all it was down to.
5 points to 2-10, like those two goals are the difference. Same number of scores, 12 scores
exactly
each,
yeah,
but two of them were goals.
So. Yeah.
Bit of a delay for the presentation, is there?
Yeah, I don't know. Is he will be bringing it up to the stand, I presume.
I don't know. Niall with COVID, we don't know what can happen.
No, that's the truth. Expect the unexpected.
Yeah, definitely. Just the captain to the
stand. Yeah. Lee Kavanagh.
Number four.
Yeah, he's a dedicated young fella. He's a player that you'd rely on every day, you know.
A leader.
Yeah, he's a leader. He's a good lad, and he deserves it now. If you miss the training, it's for a reason.
Yeah, it's not an excuse.
Yeah. Long time, 7 years down junior.
Is it, John?
Since
seven
the
years.
Reorg of the championships, told it's been down junior since then.
Okay.
After training several occasions to get over it, you know. So.
Well, the thing is now to stay intermediate.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah, that's it. That was to go up and cement yourself exactly into the.
Yeah, not just kind of.
Yeah. Working out the wrong side of the junior C last night when the Rangers won that.
Yeah, that's good. 4 or 5 years, where here and there, there was, where the same place the main was there last year. The commiseration team played, he brought up to us all the game, right? He never let us pull away with us. Keep coming back next year, right? And he'll push on again, so he'll keep that same team together, right? And he'll build on it. Thanks to all the management team there. Mick Shaw, Tom, Sham, Frank, Heavy, Mick O'Neill, Vice, everyone. Everyone's doing the club, Vice. The backness is 110%. Clubhouse getting built, up everything. It's all done, team, Vice. We're here, hopefully, if you take this now, Vice, this is our actual back piece of it. Fair play to you. Thanks for this.